Me and my cough and all, but we're back. Playing a little bit more 7 days, just having ourselves a good time. I'm going to do some hunting. Hunting, hunting, hunting. Nothing like hunting. Oh, there's a zombie. Kill me a zombie. Oh, well, well. Wasn't that a good time? That was a great time. Hey, Marifact. Thank you for the follow. You must have done that before I got back on. But thank you for the follow there. Thank you very much. And I know somebody just hosted me, so that's cool. Thank you for the host. Hi, Theora. Out doing a little bit of hunting, unless we just did a horde. I don't think we'll defend any more hordes. We'll just see what the horde can do to that house since it's solid on the ground. We'll just figure it out. See how long it'll take them to take the house down, I guess. That's what we can do. We can always build a base above it. The house comes down. Yeah, thanks a lot, Slow and Steady. Thank you very much, Slow and Steady. So how's it going? Enjoying your evening, are you? So what Badger play tonight, man? I didn't see. I didn't get an alert on my phone, which I usually do. But I didn't get one tonight, so I don't know. And it's been kind of glitchy that way. Sometimes I get the notification, sometimes I don't. Twitch has been kind of glitchy for me. See, he's been playing some The Division, which is pretty cool. What's down this road here? Oh, a little town down there. Oh, okay. Cool. Cool. That is cool. That was not bad at all. I was wondering why I didn't get a notification, but I noticed some nights I'll look and he is on, but I didn't get a notification either, so it didn't seem like it was out of the realm, you know. It does happen. A lot of friends that play that American Truck Simulator. We got a lot of them that play that. I'd have to have a controller for that. I don't think I could handle. Crawler, I don't want to deal with you either. You take way too much damage. Too many crossbow bolts to do you in. I don't want to deal with that.
User in your channel timed out.
Wild man. deer and everything else down here somewhere. Gotta be some animals. I don't want no zombies, I just want animals. Put one arrow, one crossbow bolt in each of you. Eventually, you'll die. Eventually, they will die.
Damn, I'm already out.
You're out? Well, damn, I'm out on the road right now.
But if you're now gonna look, you're gonna see how far it already goes. Did get a nice ant on it.
Cool. And we have more concrete mix. I can easily do that, but I'm headed out on a little run.
Yeah, that's fine. Give me a little bit of a break.
Almost to that other town. There's a deer. With all these zombies around. There's a lot of zombies down here, I will say that. A lot of zombies. Holy moly. There's zombies everywhere here.
Yeah, a lot of lovers for you.
Yeah. There's a little town down here too. Which is what I'm coming to see. There's a swimming pool, so there is a water source here. There's a deer in town.
Not too much in that town there.
There are a few zombies in here. Just a few. Just a few. There's one of those bunkers. There's another swimming pool in town, huh? That's two. That's two swimming pools in town.
Uh,
Doing homework is always a good thing. Keeps you out of trouble, don't it? Keeps you out of trouble, and that's what it's all about. Yo ho ho. A little protective of your property there, aren't you? There's a chicken. Big old body of water. I wonder. Yeah, there is a big old lake up here, I will say that.
That part. There's like two up there.
Yeah, there is. This one's pretty good sized. I mean, it's just outside that town, really. Takes care of her, which is good, which is good, good, good. Good, good, good. Looking for an arrow. Get feathers and eggs. Just can't pass them up. If I see one, I gotta have it. Oh, it's 90 degrees. Relax, will ya? Some pretty big lakes down here. I'm doing fine, Sandra. How are you doing? Good to see you. So I hope your morning is finding you in a fine mood and a fine day. We had a little snow here during the day, but it's going away now. But hello, buddy. Don't want to mess with you. You just go on your way, I'll go my way. Just relax. Don't get all uptight. We'll move on. Yep. Today is Good Friday. But it doesn't mean I'm going to be good. It just means the day has to be good. It doesn't mean I have to be. Doesn't mean I have to be good. That's for sure. And you know that, Sandra. You know I'm never good. How did I get across this lake? Should have come down here and built down here, man. There's a lot of water here. A lot of water. A lot of water. Build right out here in the lake itself. Don't want to mess with that barn. Barn usually means dogs. And I really don't want to mess with dogs. But I found a barn. Cool. We're supposed to warm up today, so all the snow will be gone today, so, which is okay. And I'm not anti-snow by any means. I don't mind snow. I really don't mind it. I'm more of a winter person anyway, so I don't have a problem with that. I'm not much on summer heat and humidity. I'm just not. So, there's a bear. Are you? Yeah, I'm not. Because here, I don't mind the heat, but when you have the humidity, it's just terrible. got a bear. The heat isn't bad. It's the humidity. It just feels miserable. I just don't care for the humidity. And I was born where it's hot and dry. So I'm not used to the humidity. Even though I lived most of my adult life here, I still don't like it. I can go back where I was born and sweat doesn't run down your face. It evaporates. Yep, I bet it does. Because I kind of like being outdoors too. Yep, because I like being outdoors. I like to fish. I don't fish as much as I would like to, but I do like to fish. Now that I'm semi-retired, and that's another reason why I've been trying to get me a guest streamer to stream. Yep. And it's not unusual for us here in Iowa to get 75 to 80% humidity. And it's just, oh, it's like having a wet blanket over you. You know, it's just terrible. I don't like it. Outside of that, I really like it here, except for the summer weather. It's just miserable to me. I'm like a St. Bernard. I'll go out and do what I have to do outside, then I'm back inside in the air conditioning. I don't mess with it.
Better,
it's because you're near an ocean. Yeah, it's.
Well, you would love it here.
Well, my wife and I have always said that there's three places if we had to move to a different country. It would be Australia, Canada, or Holland.
Well, I'm in one of those lucky countries.
Yes, you are. Canada's kind of down the list because it gets so much colder up there.
Isn't that great?
Well, like I said, I don't mind winter, so it wouldn't be bad for me. But my wife, she does not like the cold. She goes in a grocery store. She has to wear a jacket or a sweater because it gets too cold for her in there in the freezer. I take her to the Dairy Queen. We have a blizzard. Halfway through the blizzard, it can be 95 degrees out, and she's shivering. So the cold just goes through her like, oh my God, like a knife.
The weather here nicely balanced. It's never along too warm or too cold. Right, perfect.
Yeah. That is the downside to winter, is the snow. Yeah, I will admit to that. That is the downside to winter, but it's not the worst. Not the worst by any means. Forty-six more blocks being crafted.
Well, with that, I could finish it. Because I had already 2/3 done.
Well, we'll just have a few around for extras. Put that in there, but we'll put them in there. Yeah, Theora does too. She does. Because we'll go to the Dairy Queen once in a while and have ice cream, or blizzard as they call it. And she has a problem with that because it makes her very, very cold. She can only eat about half of it. She gets the small one. You know, and I'll look over and she'll be shivering, so cold. So here it is, like 95 degrees, and I'm over there trying to hold her, warm her up. You know what I mean? And I'm hot as hell. I don't like it. It's just too hot. But I try to warm her up. You know, it's the way it is. It's going to take a few. It's going to take a few minutes for it.
Well, that's fine. Anyway, time you can take a look.
Yeah, because we've always said that if we ever had to move, we would. We'd either be Australia, Holland, or Canada. But we love it here. I mean, but I don't know. If Donald Trump becomes president, I just don't know. I just don't know if I can. You know, I was a kid. I was bullied as a kid. And he comes across like a bully to me. And I don't think I want to live there. And deal with that. But that's just me. I did serve my country, so I am loyal to my country by every possible means, but I just don't like bullies, and he just comes across like one to me. I'm not saying he is, he just comes across that way to me. I'm going to drop 138 or 40 of them for you.
All right, I'm holding E.
There you go. Yep, that's what she says with me. You know, because it seems like whenever I crawl into bed, first thing she does, she gets up there and snuggles up to me because I'm warm.
Yeah, somebody jumps.
What happened, Red?
We might have jumped through the shaft while I was trying to start finishing off the size of the shaft.
He went right through you. Watch out, I see him up there. On down, Red. Got this all done, finally.
Got me fighting back a yawn so hard.
Oh, tell me about it. I've been doing it all night, man. I don't know. Hey, Ray, how you doing? Good to see you. Hope you had a great day today. Let's see who else is out there.
Shaft is finished.
Hey, Tupida, how you doing, Tupa? Good to see you. Snigglefritz still there. Still in the game, are you, Snigglefritz? Hey, Zeph, good to see you. Kenji, Red, slow and steady. Twitchy, good to see you. And Sandra, good to see you.
User joined your channel.
Hey, Red.
Hey, man, what's up?
Not a lot. Good to hear your voice, man.
That was not a smart move of you.
Well, if I would have known you were there, I would not have jumped.
Yeah.
I'm busy with finishing off the shaft.
All I seen was I seen you come down and shaking at the bottom, and I said, what happened to Red? Then I looked up, oh, he went right through you, didn't he?
First time I've ever done that.
Need more blocks, do you, Bob?
The shaft is now finished.
All right.
Do you have to read the riddle of steel to be able to make the steel crossbow bolt?
Yep.
For everything that's steel, you need that book.
There was one up in that box up there just inside the door yesterday. I don't know if it's still there. 25 to go. 25 what?
I think I grabbed it. I see the white book beside forged steel. So I must have grabbed it.
Yep, you must have gotten it.
Did you see the white book?
The little book next to it in your inventory, in your crafting.
Riddle of steel should be like a dark brown.
Right, yeah. What I'm saying is whenever you're in the forge and you see forged steel to the right of there's a white book.
Right, yes, I get it. Cool.
That means you did find it up there in that box.
Yes, I did.
Yep, 25 to go. Yep, I wonder if that wasn't what you were talking about. To the pie in the face, yep. That's exactly what it'll be. And I'll have to make a highlight out of that so it's always there. 24 to go. Thank you, Tic Tac. Thank you for joining the community and welcome aboard.
Hey, Tic Tac's here.
Yep, Tic Tac is here. Good to see you. Hope you had a good day today. So how was your day today, Tic Tac?
Drop it to YouTube, and then it will be always there. Because Twitch
will
for 3 months clear your VODs out.
Yep. Well, 24 more until we hit the pie in the face. Okay. Thanks for getting me closer there, Tic Tac. Thank you very much. Hope you had a good day today.
That's the guy I used to play with. He's a good guy. I've been trying to get him on this server for a while.
I'll be back with some drink.
All right. Good. Don't call me sir. I'm not sir, I'm not mister, and I'm not supreme leader. I'm just plain old death. I'm just one of the guys, all right? Just know that. Kenji's a good guy. He's really a good guy. We really like him around here.
To YouTube to do.
So, if you want to get on the server, Tic Tac, send me a friend request on Steam. Same spelling, Deathicus, same avatar. And then all I can do is I can do a quick VAC ban check on you, just like I did Kenji. And then I'll get you the information as quickly as possible. And you can be in here causing trouble with Kenji, all right? We're just kind of hanging around until Alpha 14 comes out, but you know, hey. It will drop. It will drop. Oh, yeah, and I mean that. Cause trouble with Kenji.
I don't cause trouble.
Oh, come on. You're my compadre. You know that, right?
I don't cause trouble. I'm a totally normal guy.
And when you join this community, that was out the door, man. This community is kind of like the insane asylum. You know that, right?
Yeah, it's kind of contagious.
Yeah. Anyone you like to enjoy with is welcome here. That's all I got to say.
Yeah, we don't mind to have more friends to play with.
I mean, it's really nice on the weekends when we end up with 10 or 15 of us, you know what I mean, and team speak and having a good time, man.
Well, we had already a full time a few times that the server was completely full.
Yeah, there was a few times, yeah. When Alpha 14 comes up, it may be an issue, so we don't know.
Yeah, then we have to figure out what we're going to do.
Yep. I can probably bump it up. I could probably take it to 25.
You don't make the cost too high.
Right, and that's the thing I'd have to look at. You know, with the ARC server, TeamSpeak, in 7 days, I just got to be careful with that. I have a little leeway, but not a lot, but I have some. So I may look at that when I get off tonight to see what that would take. Because we are getting a pretty vibrant seven-day crew.
In the long run, basically dump the Rust server. That way you have a little bit more leeway.
Right, and that's what I might have to do for the time being. But the 7 days,
with a few days that we did technically play it on.
Right.
There's not enough animal for that server.
Nope, and there's not enough players that want to play on it, so there's no sense having it if there's only going to be four or five of us.
You talking about Rust?
Yeah.
It's the one
I was trying to see how many wanted to play, but there's only going to be five of us on it. There's no sense, you know, having it running. Because with ARC, we have about 15. Here, we have at least 40 people who play off and on. So those two servers get used very well. And I can always bring up the Rust server later. You know, it's not that big a deal.
What I will do is make a backup of the Rust server.
Okay, that way we'd have that info if we want to bring it back up. Because that one mod is...
Info, it's more that I basically have then a complete copy of that server backed up. So if we really want to put a server back up, yeah, we could basically build it from scratch. I can even, when I get my machine back up, I can basically put it on that. Because I basically have a working version of it.
That's cool. Yeah, I figured if we could get at least 10 of us, I mean, it'd make it a decent alliance. We'd have plenty of people on there when everybody else start coming on. Otherwise, we're just going to be everybody's prey. Cool. Yeah, and that's the one thing about this community. We all love to help each other and communicate and talk and play together. And that's what I've always wanted to have in this community. That was my goal when I started streaming, to bring a community together that likes to be that way. More like a family, you know what I mean, to help each other out and have fun together. And that's what it's about. And that's what I try to do. I have to hit those. I bet you when Tony went on during the day, he hit all those doors. You probably hit all those. You know, and I might just let the hordes hit this place and see what they can do.
Eventually.
You get enough hordes on it, yeah, eventually.
Yeah, I mean, it just depends on how long you want to give it.
And I've been blessed to have the people who have joined this community up to this point. They're really good people. They love to have fun. They like to joke and hang around. Cool. Because we are kind of 7 days a day junkies here. We really do enjoy it. Even though I do play some Ark also. So some nights you'll see me split my stream. I have two streams every night. And I play half of it 7 days, half of it Ark. Because I do a 3-hour stream, take an hour off, do a 3-hour stream. And that's all I do. And I stream pretty much 7 days a week. So I get 30 plus hours every week in streaming. So... I do work part-time, so I am semi-retired. So we have fun playing together. There's Alpha 14 should be coming out soon. I would think within the next week, I would think. But you never know. You never know. You know, you just don't know. So we'll have to see if they get it out soon or not.
One thing is for sure, it will not come out in the weekend.
Well, you wouldn't think so, no.
It's basically a holiday weekend, so yeah, you won't see it.
We don't observe that here in the U.S. You work Good Friday.
It's basically a holiday weekend, and it's all over the world a holiday weekend.
And most factories still work Easter Sunday in here. They don't take it off. If they work, because most of the factories here in the town I have, they have one that they run two shifts. They're 12-hour shifts. They work 13 days on, one day off.
here again. Yeah, you only have to work when you're in a shop. Otherwise, you know. Here.
All right, Sandra. We'll see you when you get back. Take care of your kids. We do. We have a good time here, Tic Tac. And you did get us one more closer to my pie in the face. They sleep? Oh, okay. Oh, that's right. Probably no school or anything, right? Get more wood because we gotta get these suckers up and running. Well, gotta get this one going, gotta get that clay in there. Cook that clay in, get it in there. Kenji says he thinks he knows you, so that's pretty cool. Kenji's a good player, he really is. And we do teach here, we do help out a lot here, so don't be afraid about learning the game. When you get on here, once you get to us, you'll be all right. We'll get you set up, you'll be able to go out, build your own, or hang out in a community base, that's up to you. It's up to you how you want to do that, you know, so.
And, oh yeah, when you're on the server, watch out for the flyer.
Yeah, it's only Bob, so shoot him in the ass as he goes by. Because Bob is the server admin.
Why, do you not shoot me then in the ass?
Every time I see you, Fine, you're so far out of range, I couldn't hit you if I wanted to. But we do help everybody out, Dick Jackson. Do not be afraid of that.
And I know how to fly fast.
Yeah, I've seen you move. We did all this work last night and tonight between Bob and those. Bob helping out a lot. He lay it out, and all we do is make the concrete, tighten it up. So what should we else do down here now to make it more of a expansive? Put another hallway on it, maybe?
Somehow it kind of looks oddly like the old bits.
It does, except for the staircase he was building down to thing, but then Tony came across all that resources down there and just turned it into Swiss cheese. I mean, my God, look at that. I was helping him too, so I can take some of the heat too. Yeah, we were just digging the crap out of this, man.
Yeah, you were basically digging it in the roof, in the walls, and everything.
Yep, we sure were.
I'm thinking of making a room out of this.
Yeah, you could.
That's why the remaining room having all the concrete.
This is nothing. If you go to my Steam page, look at the pics, and you'll see the castle we built on the last rendition. That was an awesome build. That was an awesome build. Anyone in this community will tell you that. That castle was awesome. One of the things I was most proud of for this community. I mean, it was.
Technically, still at the castle.
Yeah, we can use it as a prefab.
I think the front bends need to make themselves built-in prefab maker. That's why you don't have to use third party of it anymore. But that one is finding yes.
Right, but at least we can still put it in as a prefab. I mean, and it was an awesome build, it really was. But we'd want to find it right away so random zombies don't tear it apart. So we could preserve it. And that house we use as our base, the bottom floor is filled solid with reinforced concrete. All there is the original wood blocks on the outside, one cobblestone block in the inside, and the rest of it's reinforced concrete. So, even if the zombies were to breach it, the house won't come down, or should, because it's sitting on a